And as you bring this higher self into this world, you must live it. You must live this love in all of your actions, in every choice you make. You must be this higher self as you live within this world in order to gain the greatest states of spiritual awakening here and now. It is not enough to escape this world into the higher self dimension. For the complete and total incarnational experience, we must merge these dimensions and live as the higher self within this physical body and radiate our love, our wisdom, our creative power here in every moment. As you create these great changes within yourself, there will be parts of your mind that will create resistance to this change. Just love it. Just be at peace with it. The teachings we have given you thus far have guided you to first create peace and stillness in these layers. You were taught to silence your mind before you opened it. You were taught to still your emotions before you created energy. You were taught to relax your body before action. And so we taught you how to purify the resistance as we led you step by step through every layer of your being. You have been given the tools. The knowledge is within you. All that is needed is a necessary reminder that when the resistance arises, do not fight against it. Do not push against the walls of your ego trying to break them down. That is an affirmation of the false self. When you fight against something, you give it more strength. When you embrace something with love, peace is created, a unity occurs, harmony develops. It is the energy of love that removes the illusion of distance. It is the energy of love that creates unity, and through this unity arises the expansion of new life. New experiences are welcomed into you through the power of love. Love does not desire to push into change. Love embraces and invites change to happen. And so throughout this series, you have been taught how to open yourself to love, how to be present with layers of mind, emotion, and body. And then once the resistance is removed, then you can act. For a fertile soil has been planted, a new foundation has been birthed, and it is in this place that your new creations will be most effectively established. Do not resist life. Do not fight against your own mind. Do not hold on to automatic emotional reactions. Break free, come back to peace, connect within your heart, return to silence, go into that state of awareness. That frees your own soul's energy from these egoic patterns. And then from that place of pure consciousness, then you create, and your creation is effective. Your creation is perfect, and the universe receives it without any interference, without any confusion, created by yourself. As you progress along the spiritual path and create new changes within yourself, you will find areas of resistance arising. They can appear within any dimension of form, be it mind, emotion, body, or world. Try not to focus too heavily upon the resistance. Allow it to be. Be at peace while it is present. Connect deeper within, not to escape from it, but just to be more of yourself while these forms are existing. Yes, the forms may exist. You may still have thoughts of resistance, emotions of resistance. You may be in a situation with other people resisting you. But as you focus into your heart and connect with your divine source of consciousness, you will establish yourself in the experience of peace. You will be that still, open, empty consciousness in which the forms are appearing. Your identification with the forms will be removed. You will be free from suffering. And people may still be there, your thoughts may still be there, but suffering will be no more. The resistance that you feel is the attachment to the forms. It is the belief that says, I am this. I am this thought, and I do not like what is. I do not like who I am. I am creating unhappiness as I resist this thought, because I am identified with this thought. It is my thought. It is me. When we resist our emotions, we try to push them and pull them, shrink them, expand them, push them to the left or to the right, push them on to other people, take them deeper within ourselves. These are all forms of identification. Do not fight. Instead, go back to your heart, return to the place of conscious clarity, and in there you will find your freedom. A freedom that has always been. Stay as this space, and your emotional suffering will silence. And then from that new foundation, then create your experience. In fact, your creation may even be that of silence. It does not need to be new emotion. It can just be peace.